So you saw the frameworks. What mean of the JavaScript frameworks? The frameworks is like your picture frame, the photo frame, like the framework collecting all the necessary libraries, and then is written pre-written JavaScript code. If you're talking about the JavaScript framework, there is a framework from Java-based framework like Spring Boot framework, the Spring frameworks, and then JSF framework, JFS frameworks, and then other type of frameworks. That means depending on which framework we are talking about, but this is the framework that's a JavaScript framework. The framework means it's collecting the other JavaScript libraries to build to provide the developer pre-written JavaScript code, and then those code you integrate to a web application or front-end application, and quickly and build and very efficiently and flexible way to build the web pages, website, and web application or web development. That's why the framework really important when you are developing the really professional web application or websites developments. So we need to be understand what the framework means, that it's collecting the individuals libraries for which is required for your application development, your front-end application or web development application. If you saw the picture below, that's the most popular JavaScript frameworks like Angular. That's I have it in example my channels, the two or three examples. And then it's collecting all the dependencies, all the JavaScript dependencies that I need, and then I very quickly and efficiently and professional way as a build an enterprise web application. That's why the frameworks is really important to get it. But before to understand the frameworks, you need to understand the JavaScript itself. How it works, how can you integrate, how can you manipulate, how can you program it in the JavaScript itself. Then if you get a really clear idea how the JavaScript works, and then you can start after the JavaScript frameworks, because the frameworks make life easier for the developer. Those who are the front-end or web developer, it's like make life really, really easier to build the web application or front-end application. That's the framework is doing for you. So you see the most popular frameworks. This I have example like Angular, React, Vue, and also and so forth. And too many JavaScript frameworks make more flexible and helps the developer to build their web application. That's the framework is doing. So get the idea what I mean, and just you can also Google it detail about how the framework works. But I am trying to do the really abstract level information from my career, how I learn it, just like it is collecting all the other dependencies that you need or that you require for very specific functionalities for building your web application. That's the framework is doing. So now is the core part, what I mean, JavaScript. So it is JavaScript is a very simple, lightweight programs and programming language, a scripting programming language, I can say. You can run it cross platform, doesn't matter, is a desktop or is a mobile or smart devices or any platform it is possible to run, even though depending on the OS systems, it is also the OS independent. Scripting language. It's you see that the major part web development domain. So basically JavaScript is more focused or more basically main focus is the web development domain. So without JavaScript, I believe I didn't find any without JavaScript, or even though without any JavaScript framework, you cannot develop like the web development like that way. So JavaScript basically it's more focused the web development as a front-end development that we need. So here's I've written down to really summarize, but you can Google it and get it more overview about that. And JavaScript can change the your HTML components. That's why I'm written down here the basic and attributes for the HTML, and even though the CSS control, the CSS attribute control. So that's all things you run into the your front-end. What do you front-end return, validation, content check, attribute check, and styling change, and all things together. So in general, what I mean, if you think about it as a really complete web applications, application level, where the JavaScript can play the role or playing the role, basically, this is the one of the really key points you need to understand. Client-side validation, that means you have a very simple, very effective and reactive type of validation forms, and you need to validate in the client side. So it is possible to validate in the bot side, in the server side, and client side. The server side validation done by the server, maybe you REST APIs or your Java server or in the on the other side, and then you the as a front-end developer, the JavaScript developer or front-end developer, you need to be validate your input forms. That's why it is really important. It's playing the really big role for JavaScript for the validation in the client side. So that means that the validation playing two side in the server side and client side. Server one is done by the API developer or microservice developer, even though in the SQL level validation in the server part, and then client side you are responsible to validate your forms or input forms or all sort of the web part of the your checks. So you see the manipulating HTML pages, that's I mean, that's it here, the content and user notification, all sort of notifications for the email notifications or email sending notifications or download, upload notification, all things information is possible with the JavaScript notification. Backend data loading, that's the popular third-party JavaScript library, AJAX library. You can call the AJAX and then build your backend data manipulation. It's in modern days, the JavaScript 5 or modern JavaScript programming is possible to directly communicate with your backend servers with building with the REST APIs inside or WebSocket or REST API or other services. That's why nowadays JavaScript is more capable and the browser is capable to handle the backend communication and the backend services call to this one. So this is one of the example the AJAX library can do that for you. But in the professional life, normally the server part is done by the API developer, microservice developer, or backend developer. And then give it to you the really service level or REST services or web services or SOAP services. Doesn't matter which type of service you get, you just consume the services, load the data, and do them all the manipulation in your front-end level. That's the really segregation. But now the modern JavaScript can do, even though in the backend level, even though in the server levels, the server application, that's I said in the Node.js, that's I have it in a previous example. There's many examples how can you start the server communication or server setup, all things data processing or data backend data handling is done by the Node.js, and then you build the Angular based front end, and then it works automatically. Or you have your own Angular based front end technology, very simple Angular frameworks, and then you call the REST services, build your web application. Just look for my channel. There's many example how can you do it with APIs in the backend APIs and call it and build your REST server, your front end. So now is a little bit programming that I tried to start with you. Because you see that's one of the big questions from the very beginners. They need to be clearly understand. If you are the professional, that's not a big jobs, but a big task. But as if you are as a beginner, you need to understand where you can place your JavaScript programs or JavaScript logic or JavaScript functions or whatever it is you call. There is only four places you can put the JavaScript into your front end, into your HTML page. You can put their header sections that I will show you later in one example. You can put also the JavaScript into the body section, and then you can combine the body section and head section. That means you can both side you have JavaScript, you can manipulate or you can write.